Welcome to the MSP Gang Production Programmer Workshop, where we will run through a brief demo on how to use the MSP Gang to program your devices. By the end of this video, you will know two things. What is the MSP Gang Production Programmer, and why do I need it? And how to use the MSP Gang Production Programmer. Let's get started. So what is the MSP Gang? The MSP Gang is a production-level programmer that programs MSP devices. This programmer can program up to 8 MSP devices at a time. These devices can be MSP 430 or 432 devices, with either flash or FRAM memory. The MSP Gang connects to the host PC via an RS-232 standard connection or a USB connection. The MSP Gang allows for flexible programming options to customize the programming process. The MSP Gang comes with a USB connector, a power adapter, the MSP Gang splitter board, and the MSP Gang production programmer itself. To assemble the MSP Gang, plug in the DC jack, attach the splitter board, and connect the devices you want to program. The MSP Gang software consists of three parts: the firmware, the Dynamic Link Library, or DLL, and the graphical user interface. Download the MSP Gang software from TI.com to get started. This is the software GUI for the MSP Gang. This is the easiest, most interactive way to get started programming your devices. For a typical setup sequence, choose the setup mode, select the target MCU, select the code file containing the target application code, and configure the target's power supply source, voltage, current limit, and settle time options. Choose the desired interface between the target and MSP Gang. Choose the memory options. The memory options are separated into two parts. The left side is for erase, program, and verify, while the right side is for readback operation. The update only setting is best when you need to program in more than one step. When selected, the Go operation memory contents are not erased. The All Memory setting erases all memory before programming. The Main Memory setting leaves any information memory unchanged. The Used By code file setting allows you to modify segments of main or info memory. When you're done selecting the memory options, press OK on the Memory Options dialog box. Next, enable or disable the required target devices from 1 to 8. Now verify the settings by pressing the Go button, and see the pass/fail results. In the results window, the left is an example of a successful programming sequence, and the right side is an example of a failing one. To save your current settings for later use, click the Save Project As button in the File drop-down menu. The Open Project button can be loaded later and modified if necessary to access these files. There is also the Save Image File As button, which allows you to save as an image file. An image contains the code files and necessary configuration options for programming of a target device. When the Save Image As button is clicked, the Image Name screen appears. Enter up to 16 characters that you want to show up on the LCD display on the MSP Gang, and click the OK button. After that, a second screen pops up where you can enter a PC file name. Enter your file name and press Save. Congratulations! You have successfully learned how to set up, configure, and use the MSP Gang for production-level programming. Visit the link shown for more information. Thanks for watching.